funny. No, I only dreamt about doing these things. All those lonely nights in the office, those weekends, playing out all these torture scenarios in my head. Thinking about it again and again.
You can't imagine what I've come up with.
Whatever you're thinking of doing, please don't.
Paper cuts. Now they can be a bitch. Occupational hazard, I guess. But I'll bet it's been a while since you've had one, huh? Me? I'm starting to get used to them. Stings, doesn't it? Well, like I said, you'll get used to them. Now, the ones that I could never handle. Say ah. Come on.
Don't.
You're only gonna make it harder on yourself. Forget about the shitty mint flavor on these things. The real pain in the ass is when you get a paper cut on your tongue. Buddy Ackman's off. Hello, Mishka. No, he's not in. Mishka, Buddy is devoted to only you. Well, I'll tell you what you do. Get your cute little butt over to his house by midnight. Okay. Bye-bye.
This could be the biggest picture of the year. Real life, directed by Foster Kane. I like it. It smells of money. It was a great idea bringing Dawn and Foster together. I would have never thought of that. I gotta admit, you may not be a complete idiot after all. Your ideas here aren't half bad, but I hate the title, I hate the ending. It's too depressing.
Okay.
Come out to the house this weekend and we'll figure something out. I'll leave the key for you. Now, you think we're gonna be ready for Cyrus by next week?
Cyrus? Don't you think we ought to wait for Stella to get back?
Stella, fuck her! Listen, we take this to Stella, she's just gonna take credit for all your work, for all of our work. No, fuck her. It's kill or have your contract terminated early. No, no. We need to go directly to the top. We need to go to Cyrus.
But hold on a second. Dawn's bringing the project to Stella. Remember, you passed.
You like Dawn, don't you? You consummate the relationship?
Dawn? I mean, Dawn and I...
Give a fuck? Listen, I'm just saying... Shut up and listen. Women, they respond to one thing and one thing only. Success. Now, this isn't just me talking. This is Sit down. This is scientific fact. It is primitive instinct for a woman like Dawn to choose a mate who can best provide for her needs, for her wants. Now, it's no offense to you, but... you are only an assistant. Sure, I mean, you're my assistant, but, you know, nonetheless, you know, an assistant. Dawn, on the other hand, is a producer. Her car phone bills are more than your rent. So just how long do you think you're going to last?
Dawn and I, we
you,
just...
All right, I want to help out. Because if you put this project together, you're not going to be just the assistant any longer. So, I'm gonna give you the chance to play hero. You get to be Dawn's white knight in shining armor. You have to convince Dawn to bring the project back to me, not to Stella, to me. Now, I could do it, but there'd be no payoff for you.
I just don't know how it would...
You do this thing. You convince Don to go this way. And then you and I are going to run this place. The both of us.
All right. I'll do it. You said it was indispensable. Look, he gave me a beeper. I think he's beginning to respect me. I think he's really beginning to respect me.
No, Guy, please wake up. He's just got you on a shorter leash, that's all. Oh, you're doing it all wrong. Move. So, let me guess. He gave you that team horseshit, right? Win one for us, you and me. Exactly what is it that we are supposed to do?
Not much. To find a new title, new ending. When you have to cancel your meeting with Stella.
Unbelievable.
No, listen. All Stella wants to do is take credit for your work. Now, I already convinced Buddy to go directly to Cyrus. Now, he can't do that if you pitch it to Stella. I don't want to jeopardize your relationship with Stella. I'm sorry, but this is the only way...
Stop. Do not apologize. It's a sign of weakness. Move. Don't tell me what needs to be done, Guy. I know the drill. The politicking, the compromises, the spilling of coffee on ourselves and the race to kiss ass.
Actually, Buddy did that. I let his coffee get cold and he threw it at me. But I learned a valuable lesson. Never let Buddy's coffee get cold.
And this?
It's a bagel stain.
Bagel stain?
Yeah, well, I put too much cream cheese on his bagels. He threw it at me. But again, I learned a very valuable lesson. Never put too much cream cheese on Buddy's bagels.
Yeah, he really respects you. I think we should wait.
No,
and I want to go to Stella.
No, but Buddy wants to do this now. Look, if this picture is big, think about what we could do. We'll go make our own movies. We just have to deal with Buddy on this one. Do you hate me? Is that it? I mean... You do. You hate me.
Oh, God, I don't hate you. I just want you to make the right choice.
I say we go with Buddy.
Okay. But know this. I have seen what he can do. You cannot get into bed with him without getting fucked. He plays a zero-sum game. That's his drill. Nobody wins unless somebody loses.
And, well, as long as I don't lose you. Loss. They say that real pain, real suffering, is caused from loss. Loss of family. Loss of love. Loss of the things that matter most. I like it. It's a little different look for you, but I... Okay. Now, let's forget all the other shit we've been doing here tonight, okay? Let's start thinking big. Grand. Abbondante, if you will. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.